Hi there, I'm John Riddle, and I've got another free tutorial for you again today. Now, have you ever heard of GIMP 3? If you haven't, you're going to be pleasantly surprised because it is a powerful open-source tool for editing and managing drawings and images, and it's absolutely free to use for Windows, macOS, and Linux users. So sit back and relax, and let me show you how to use it right now. When you open GIMP, you get a blank canvas with several panels and tabs around it. If anything is missing, make sure to open what you need from Windows Dockable Dialogues. You can also customize the color of the interface by going to Edit, Preferences, Theme, and go to Color Scheme Variant. To open an image, go to File, Open. At this point, you can crop it by enabling the Crop tool and clicking and dragging on it, cutting anything outside the grid just made. Apply the crop by clicking on any of the corners of the grid. Now, let's see how to draw with the tools collected in the toolbox on the left. Some of these may collect additional tools, as you can see, by right-clicking on any button. To draw on your image, click and drag on the canvas using the pencil tool for a hard stroke, the airbrush tool for a softer stroke, or the paintbrush tool for a balanced stroke. Hold down the Shift key to draw straight and adjust the brush options on the left, such as brush or blending modes, opacity, size, angle, and hardness. You can also set dynamic options to adjust the stroke according to your cursor movements and speed. On the top, set the brush color as foreground color, or simply hold down the Control key to pick any color from the canvas. On the right, select any brush style from the Brushes dialog, or create your own brush by going to Create below. You can also enable the My Paintbrush tool to get further brush styles. To undo any action, use Control or Command and Z, or head to the History dialog on the left. GIMP collects several tools to correct images. Enable the Clone tool to adjust the image by pasting pixels from a given reference point. Just hold down the Control or the Command key and click to fix the reference. Then brush over the areas of the image. The Healing tool is very similar to the Clone tool, with the difference being that it takes into account the original colors of the image when you brush. Enable the Smudge tool to click and drag pixels, adjusting brush options on the left. With the Blur Sharpen tool, you can brush to increase the blurriness, holding the Control or Command key to reduce it. Enable the Dodge Burn tool to increase brightness, holding Control or Command to reduce it. Zoom in and out on your canvas by holding the Control or Command key and using your mouse wheel, and pan around by holding the spacebar key. Make sure to use the Tab key to preview in full screen mode, pressing it again to retrieve all tabs and dialogues around the canvas. By default, the image imported is a single bitmap object called Layer, listed in the Layers dialog on the right. This also means that any drawing made on the canvas overwrites the image content permanently. To prevent this, create a new layer by clicking the New button at the bottom and place it above your image. This way, if you select the new layer and draw, you preserve the original image. From the layer dialog, use the eye icon to toggle the visibility of each layer and click under the lock column to prevent specific modifications. Drag any layer up or down to adjust its order of visibility. Enable the eraser tool to brush over your strokes to refine or delete these. If you use this tool on an image, deleted pixels show the background color by default, chosen on the left. If you want erased areas to be transparent, right-click on the image layer and go to Add Alpha Channel. This adds a new color channel called Alpha, as you can see from the channel dialog, which allows transparency to the image. From the Color tab, you can apply advanced color corrections such as hue, saturation, exposure, shadows and highlights levels, brightness, and contrast while checking the canvas preview. You can also apply effects from the Filters tab, including blur or lens distortion. These corrections and filters are added to the selected layer on the right, which shows an FX icon with the list of all the effects applied. From here, you can disable or enable each effect. Adjust their order with the arrow buttons below, or adjust the properties of the selected effect with the Edit button. You can use the Transform tools to manage and modify entire layers. From the Layer dialog, select the layer in which you're interested and enable the Unified Transform tool to edit it. Click and drag the layer to move it, holding down the Shift key to move horizontally or vertically. Drag from the squared nodes to resize while preserving the aspect ratio unless you hold the Shift key. Drag the diamond nodes to distort the layer in perspective and drag from outside to rotate, holding Shift to rotate by 15 degrees. Use the Fill Diamond nodes to shear. Right-click on the Transform button to go to flip the layer horizontally or vertically if you hold the Control or Command key. Enable Warp Transform to brush and drag pixels more precisely rather than the Smudge tool, and the Cage Transform tool to drop a polygon by clicking on the canvas and edit the enclosed area by dragging the vertices. In GIMP, you can also select specific areas to delimit where to drop your drawings or apply your filters to the selected layer. Use the Rectangle or the Ellipse Select tool to select by clicking and dragging on the canvas. With the Free Select tool, you can click on the canvas to drop vertices and click and drag to draw freehand until you close the shape. To remove any selection, press Ctrl plus Shift and A or Command plus Shift and A. When you select any region, use Ctrl or Command and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste. The pasted copy is a new independent layer. This copy-paste operation is very useful to import an image into another in the same canvas. Let's see how to draw vectors. These differ from images, as their shapes are defined by math algorithms instead of pixels, ensuring no quality loss when you edit them. You can start from a new canvas from File, New. Select any template and set the canvas size and orientation. On Advanced Options, head to Fill With to set where you want a solid white color or a fully transparent background for the canvas. At this point, enable the Paths tool to start drawing vectors. Click on the canvas to drop straight segments and click and drag to drop curves. Use Ctrl or Command and Z to undo if you make any mistakes. To finish drawing, double-click on the last node or hold Ctrl or Command and click on the first node to close the shape. When editing the path, pay attention to the cursor shape. According to it, you can click and drag any node to move it. Drop new nodes when you see a small square. Shape the path directly or adjust the curves by moving the handles. Once the path is done, use the fill and stroke path options on the left to apply any fill or outline. All your vectors are listed in the Paths dialog on the right, separated from the bitmap layers. Fill and stroke applied remain saved in the layers selected while editing the path. To drop text, enable the Text tool and click once on the canvas to type in. Select text to edit its properties, such as font, size, style, and color, as you like. Text is placed as an independent layer that you can move and modify with the Transform tool. You can also go to Layer Text to Path to convert text to a path listed in the Paths dialog. This way, you can customize text with the Paths tool. To save your work, go to File, Save As. Set Name, Destination Folder, and select File Format at the bottom. Select XCF to save all the layers, paths, and options within your canvas to edit it later in GIMP. To render your canvas as an image, go to File, Export As, selecting a JPEG format or a PNG format if you have to save any transparency level or alpha channel. To export any vector path, select it from the Paths dialog, right-click on it, and go to Export Paths to save these in an SVG vector format. There you have it, and we hope you enjoyed watching our tutorial today on GIMP 3, and we hope you learned some useful tips out of that you can use when you're using this fine piece of software. And don't forget, for more free tips, tricks, and other tutorials, be sure to visit our website or our YouTube channel. And ladies and gentlemen, we will see you next time.